On a little dare, but now she's missing class and she's dropping her pom-poms. Nobody knows where she is, not even her mom.
You remember this PSA last year during the Super Bowl? It was locally produced by the National Council on Alcoholism and Drug Abuse, and it talked to the growing problem of heroin and opioid abuse in this area and the many young lives taken as a result. Well, the NCADA has produced a new spot that will air this Super Bowl Sunday. And Howard Weissman is the executive director of the NCADA here to talk about it. For those who don't remember, you got a lot of different kind of reaction to that spot last year. Some good, some not so good.
The vast majority of the feedback that we received was positive. You know, it treats an unpleasant message.
Absolutely.
And we did nothing to glamorize the consequences of a heroin addiction, and not everybody liked the treatment, but it got many people talking, and that was part of the objective.
That was the point, right? Yeah. That was the point. And you're doing it again this year. You've produced yet another spot. I think we did a news story on it recently. This too is meant to open some eyes.
Right. Actually, we've produced two different spots, and they will both be running during the Super Bowl. The first during the first break in halftime, the second right before the start of the third quarter. We don't even mention heroin this year, Randy. The ads are about the safe storage and disposal of prescription medication, especially prescription painkillers.
And that is the message you hope to convey. And unlike last year you had an anonymous donor who gave you the money to produce that. That is not the case this year.
That is not the case this year. You know, the epidemic is changing, it's dynamic, and it requires new strategies. And that requires new partners. And this year, we're very pleased to be working with the DEA in their DEA 360 strategy. And the DEA has actually purchased the airtime for us so that we're able to run these during the Super Bowl.
And you are going to be having, I guess, I won't say an unveiling, but sort of a screening of these Super Bowl ads on...
Tonight.
That's tonight, 4 p.m. at your offices on Olive. And then you're also going to have other people there. Who else will be attending this?
Well, the screening tonight is for everybody who's got skin in the game, for parents who've lost children, for public health officials, for law enforcement, for treatment providers. I invited a number of people who I thought would be interested, and the response was overwhelming. Mm-hmm. It's going to be standing room only tonight. We have a waiting list. So there's great interest in the new spots. We're excited about them. I'm always nervous, you know, before we see what the reaction is, but we're confident that these will be effective.
I will say, before we came on, I did have a look at the entire 60-second spot, and it was impactful. That's the word I'm going to use, so make sure you watch out for it. Do you know where in the game it's going to be placed?
The first spot will air during the first break in halftime,
okay.
The second right before the start of the third quarter.
And what do you hope happens after this? You need support at the NCADA. What do you hope people do?
Well, really what I want people to do is take action. I want people to go to their medicine cabinets, and if they have any unneeded pain medication, I want them to throw them in a Ziploc bag, add some water or some Pine Sol, and throw it in the trash. I want people to drop them off in a drug disposal box. I want people to use one of our Deterra drug disposal pouches, which they can get for free. I want people to lock up their prescription medication, especially the addictive prescription pain medication.
Because obviously, that is a gateway to opioid abuse.
4 out of 5 heroin users did start with prescription opioids. And parents need to know that these are highly addictive drugs. And, you know, their kids could be playing Russian roulette
right.
with, you know, the loaded revolvers they left in the medicine cabinet. So it's important to get these out of the house as soon as you can, or to lock them up.
If this affects you, your family, your friends in any way, this is something you definitely need to pay attention to. The screening is tonight. The new PSA will be posted online starting tomorrow after the screening.
The screening is today. The ads will go online tomorrow afternoon.
Got it. So if you want to see them, they always could use your help, your input, and we have a link to their website on our website, as well as information about the screening on the website, as well as our Fox 2 News app. Thank you for joining us again.
My pleasure.
We appreciate it. John?